Yep, that's where he gave his biggest speech. Dear Tim and Moby, can you do a Martin Luther King movie? Thanks, Amari. The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was one of the most important leaders of the American Civil Rights Movement. That was the effort to extend equal rights to all people, regardless of race. Well, in the first half of the 20th century, that was a controversial idea. In many parts of the country, African Americans were barred from participating in ordinary life. They couldn't eat at the same lunch tables, go to the same schools, or even use the same bathrooms as white people. This practice of separating African Americans from white people was called segregation. In the South, segregation was enforced through Jim Crow laws. They made it illegal for African Americans to mix with whites. They policed black behavior, too. African Americans had to live in separate neighborhoods, hold specific jobs, and talk to whites with the utmost respect. Try to fight it, and you risk jail time, injury, even death. There were no Jim Crow laws up north, but unspoken rules still kept African Americans apart. In many places, white homeowners would only sell their houses to other white people. These informal codes ensured that African Americans remained second-class citizens. Martin Luther King grew up in the midst of all that inequality. He was born in 1929 to a middle-class family in Atlanta, Georgia. Both his grandfather and his father were pastors at a local church. King attended religious colleges up north, in Philadelphia and Boston. He noticed black and white people mixing more freely than he'd seen growing up. Though these cities had their share of racial tension, they were a far cry from the way things were down south. Dr. King moved to Montgomery, Alabama with his wife, Coretta, in 1953. He became a pastor and community leader. Around that time, a local woman named Rosa Parks was arrested for refusing to give her bus seat to a white man. King joined forces with activist Joanne Robinson to organize a massive boycott of the Montgomery bus system. Most black citizens of Montgomery refused to ride the buses for over a year. Many were violently attacked just for walking instead of taking a bus. Dr. King's house was bombed, and along with dozens of other protesters, he was thrown in jail. But these injustices drew national attention to the issue. And in 1956, a Supreme Court decision banned segregated buses. After that victory, King helped organize a group of churches dedicated to nonviolent protests for civil rights. He was inspired by the life of Mahatma Gandhi, whose nonviolent leadership helped free India from British rule. Over the next decade, King led protests and marches all over the country. The biggest was the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom in 1963. Hundreds of thousands of people gathered in the nation's capital to support civil rights. It was there that Dr. King delivered his momentous I Have a Dream speech.
One day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
Yeah, kind of gives you goosebumps, doesn't it? King's gift for public speaking helped inspire millions of people. His words gave them the hope and courage to believe in the future he envisioned. 2 years later, the protests he led throughout Alabama caught the world's attention. People watched in shock as local police turned fire hoses and attack dogs on peaceful protesters. Well, people often feel threatened by change. In fact, making folks uncomfortable was kind of the point of all this protest. In a letter written from an Alabama jail, King said, "Nonviolent direct action seeks to create such a crisis and establish such creative tension that a community that has constantly refused to negotiate is forced to confront the issue." In other words, things change only when conditions are made so stressful people demand it. Oh yeah, King was arrested lots of times during these marches, but the result was worth it. His work pressured Congress to pass groundbreaking laws moving society closer to his vision. The Civil Rights Act of 1964 and the Voting Rights Act of 1965 overturned segregation laws around the country. In 1964, he was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. He went on to fight against poverty and the Vietnam War. Then in 1968, Martin Luther King was assassinated in Memphis, Tennessee. His killer, James Earl Ray, was captured months later. King was only 39 years old, but in his short life, he'd changed the face of this country. Without his influence, who knows how long it would have been before equal rights were protected for everyone. Yeah, you're right. We still struggle with racial equality to this day. But thanks to Dr. King and other civil rights leaders, we know that great change is possible.
I have a dream today.
Has anybody seen old friend Abraham? Can you tell me where he's gone? He freed a lot of people, but it seemed the good die young. I looked around and he was gone. Anybody here see my old friend John Kennedy? Can you tell me where he's gone? He freed a lot of people, but it seemed the good die young. Anybody here see my old friend Martin Luther King? Can you tell me where Martin is gone?
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing.
I say to you today, my friends.
I say to you today, my friends.
Even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream.
I still have a dream.
I still have a dream.
It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed.
We hold these truths to be self-evident. That all men
all people
are created,
are created equal.
Toda la gente fue creada igual.
I have a dream that one day, on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood.
I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice,
sweltering with the heat of oppression,
will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children...
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day little black boys and little black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and little white girls as sisters and brothers.
I have a dream today.
Yo tengo un sueño hoy.
I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted and every hill and mountain shall be made low. The rough places will be made plain and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed in all flesh. shall see it together.
This is our hope.
This is our faith.
With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into
the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
With this faith, we'll be able to work together.
A trabajar juntas y juntos.
To pray together.
To struggle together.
To go to jail together.
To stand up for freedom together.
Knowing that we will be free one day.
My country.
This will be the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with a new meaning, My country, 'tis of thee. Sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing.
Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring.
Let freedom ring.
Que suene la libertad.
Let freedom ring.
And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true.
This must become
this
true.
This must become true.
This must become true.
Let freedom ring.
So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California. But not only that.
But not only that. Let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia.
Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain in Tennessee.
Let freedom ring from every hill and every molehill of Mississippi, from every mountainside. Let freedom ring. And when this happens, when we allow freedom to ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet,
from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day.
We'll be able to speed up that day when all God's children,
black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics,
will be able to join hands and sing in the words of that old Negro spiritual.
Free at last.
Free at last.
Finalmente libres.
Free at last.
Free at last.
Free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.